XFM News. On point. The news on XFM. I'm Chris Otim. The former Citizens Coalition for Electoral Democracy Programs coordinator, Crispin Kaheru, wants a peaceful pact for the general elections to be signed between the presidential candidates and security forces. Kaheru cited the ongoing tensions between the two entities during the campaign trails, which he says necessitates a shared role for the promotion of peaceful elections. It is on this that he has challenged the heads of the three arms of government to champion the signing of the pact with an objective of securing peaceful elections.
It is now time to get the presidential political candidates to sign an election peace pact. Given the escalating circumstances, formal and informal institutions, including the heads of government organs such as the judiciary, parliament, and the executive, must quickly act together with other influential non-government actors to impress it upon presidential candidates to take a stand against electoral violence, take a stand against impunity, and take a stand against injustice, as well as commit to a peaceful election and judicial resolution of electoral disputes.
The UPC party leadership under the city lawyer Peter Waluwidi want all the people that were arrested during the Free Bobi Wine protests to be released. The party's communications envoy, Tom Omino, noted in the statement that the killing of more than 50 people is indicative of unprofessional conduct by the security forces, which should stop. He stated that every person has a right of life, asking all the detainees to be released unconditionally, since their long detention violates the law. The anti-graft body, Transparency International Uganda boss Peter Wandeda, wants the inquiry into the financial fraud accusations against the presidential advisors Catherine Kusasida and Hilary Chisanja to be expedited. The duo allegedly conspired with one Mugisha Mondo and Siraj of Bombo and defrauded about 5,000 pastors of their monies under the State House cover, which prompted their questioning by the State House anti-corruption unit. Now, Wandeda says action should be taken against whoever will be found guilty to serve as an example to the corrupt.
What should be important is what happens after a person has been found to be corrupt. What action is taken? For example, the Kusasira case, we are looking to see what is going to happen. Will she be prosecuted? Will it be investigated? Yes, yeah, so once that is done, then we shall be sure that actually the fight against corruption is working. But if no investigation takes place, no prosecution takes place, then there is a gap. Whoever is involved, we shouldn't look at who is involved. Let's look at what happens to the person who is involved.
Medics want politicians at the different levels to use this campaigning period to mobilize Ugandans to donate blood so as to solve the problem of blood shortages in hospitals. One of the medics from Nakasero Blood Bank, Samuel Davis Wante, says that during campaigns, the demand for blood increases as a result of several injuries people get during campaign drives, hence the need for politicians to mobilize their supporters to donate blood so as to revive the situation.
In this period, we request everybody that is responsible to mobilize people to donate blood. These should be politicians, stakeholders of various organizations to encourage their followers, all the people they need to donate blood. Because the demand of blood in this period has gone high, our country is in a lot of activity. It's in campaigns, political rallies, whereby people are exposed to a lot of dangers that might result in loss of blood. So we encourage all people in focal positions to encourage whoever they come across to donate blood.
Wante adds that this campaign should be embraced by all politicians, both in the opposition and those in government institutions.
The other request I'm making, let them spare us. We had a terrible experience on the 18th, whereby we were so much harassed when we were collecting blood to save Ugandans. Yes, we work for government, but we are government ourselves. Even people in opposition are government. Kindly, we are not any partisan. Let them encourage people to donate blood, and we are for the good cause and the patriotic cause.
And Africa News. Ghanaians are going to the polls to elect a new president and parliament in a country seen as one of the most democratic in Africa. 11 candidates are in the race to unseat President Nana Akufo-Addo, who is running for his second term. His main challenger is his predecessor and 2016 opponent, John Dramani Mahama. Youth unemployment, security concerns, and the effects of COVID-19 on the economy of Ghana are among the top issues the Ghanaians will consider when voting today. In world news, at least 6 people, including 5 coronavirus patients, have died in a hospital in Pakistan after oxygen supplies ran too low. A reported delay in deliveries meant more than 200 patients were left for hours on a reduced oxygen at the government-run hospital in the northern city of Peshawar on Saturday. Hospital officials described the shortage as criminal negligence, blaming it on the supply company. Pakistan is fighting a new virus wave. It has so far reported more than 400,000 infections and over 8,000 deaths. In sports, Premier League champions Liverpool welcomed the return of fans to Anfield for the first time since March with an emphatic 4-0 victory over Wolverhampton Wanderers. Harry Kane believes both he and attacking partner Son Heung-min are entering the prime of their careers after their goals helped Tottenham overcome arch rivals Arsenal 2-0 and return to the top of the Premier League table. And that's the latest XFM News. XFM News on point.